My guest is Dr. Kim, who is the Director of Adventist Mission right here in the Northern Asia Pacific region. Dr. Kim, welcome.
Yeah, it's good to meet you.
Now, when we talk about mission here in Northern Asia Pacific region, it's a priority, right?
Yes, I mean, of course.
I see the slogan everywhere, mission first.
Yeah, mission first, yes.
So what does that mean?
Yes, we have great challenges to reach the people in our territories in terms of population. NSD is the largest division in the world. Yeah, we have a lot of people live in the city, of course, live in the rural countries, but we need to reach them with the gospel message of Jesus Christ and urgent news of the second coming of Jesus Christ.
Yes, now, when we look at the region that you care for, you have, of course, the vast territories of China.
Yes.
And you also have Mongolia. Now, Mongolia, they both have like a communist history.
That's right, yeah.
Tell me about the church in Mongolia. It's relatively young, I understand.
Yeah, Mongolia, about 22 years ago, there was none single Adventist members in the country. But we are really blessed. A missionary from United States volunteered to come to a great country, Mongolia, and stay in the country as a missionary. Mm-hmm. For the first time, she was not able to do anything, but she was willing to be mingled with the people in Mongolia, and little by little, she was able to share about Jesus Christ. After 2 years of her service, finally, two young ladies accepted Jesus Christ as their personal savior. That was the beginning, and since that moment, so far, we have a little more than 2,000 members in the country of Mongolia. Now we have 31 churches in the country of Mongolia.
Wow. Mm. The history is very interesting because, as you say, it was a missionary couple from a supporting ministry, Adventist Frontier Missions,
yes,
who came here, and then the church has grown. And what appeals to me is that how we have local leadership now growing up. Some of those young people who were baptized way back then now are pastors and leaders.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. What is good is the many young people in Mongolia. They really like to join the church for the first time through the missionary effort. Later, some pastors and some missionaries came to Mongolia. Yeah, a lot of young people are joining the church. And then these young people grew in spiritually, and they became the leader of the church.
Wonderful.
So now they are leading the Mongolian church and many mission activities.
Wonderful. Now, when we look at global mission activities here in your territory, I see that here in Korea and in many other countries, you have many centers of influence.
Yes.
Can you describe for me some of the centers and what they are doing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like the concept of the center of influence given by the Ellen G. White and also the given by the General Conference leadership. Center of influence really important to reach the people really in the center of the city. The simple gospel message, direct Bible teaching, sometimes it is not easy to meet the people. But if we work for their needs through the center of influence, like health message and caring young children, and many ways that we can reach through the center of influence. So maybe we, Korea, more than 100 centers of influence that we have in the church, and then these activities are very strong. Through this center of influence, we may reach more people and that we can share the good news of salvation. And especially in China, so far we have 48 centers of influence in the mainly large cities. It is very active to contact the people through the concept of the center of influence.
Wonderful. Now, as the coordinator for Adventist Mission here, you have a very strong focus on church planting.
Yes, right.
Why is church planting so important?
Yeah, so church planting, I believe, this is the, one of the best way to increase the number of the church member and the, form the Christian group of people in the unentered area. So without church planting, we cannot expand the kingdom of God. Church planting, I think, this is the best way to expand the kingdom of God in our generation.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
What is your greatest hope as Adventist Mission Director here for this territory? What is your greatest hope to see happen in the next few years?
Yeah, the mission is really dynamic. It's challenging. Sometimes it seems impossible in the eyes of human beings, but in faith, believe in God. God is almighty. If God is with us, we can do everything, especially in the mission of the Lord. In the NS territories, we have large cities, but we couldn't enter yet with the gospel message. So our focus is to penetrate all the cities, especially in China, in Japan, in Korea, and other countries. If we can go to those cities with the gospel message, I think that many people will be harvested and they are ready for the second coming of Jesus Christ.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Dr. Kim, for joining us today.
Thank you very much. Yeah, thank you.
And viewers at home, please pray for the territories of the Northern Asia Pacific region, vast countries, so many different cultures, languages, people groups, and as Dr. Kim has reminded us, huge cities full of apartments, full of precious people who many of them have not yet heard of the love of God.